Fox News was forced to admit that the economy is booming under Joe Biden after a blockbuster jobs report on Friday that stunned everyone, and yet Donald Trump is still somehow trying to take credit for the good economic news, which has left even some Fox hosts bewildered. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. We are living in weird times dominated by weird people who talk about weird for like an entire week, the biggest topic of conversation in right-wing media was the MAGA conspiracy theory that the Super Bowl was somehow rigged for the Chiefs so that Taylor Swift could endorse Joe Biden, which is obviously insane. The Super Bowl hasn't been rigged since 2011 when my Steelers lost to the Packers in a game which was obviously rigged. And if you don't believe me, feel free to order my handwritten manifesto on the subject, available only on the dark web because the man doesn't want you to read about it. Even Joe Biden has noticed how weird things have gotten thanks to Trump and his goons.
You know, the folks are starting to focus in. And the guy we're running against, he's not for anything. He's against everything. Yeah. No, I mean, it's the weirdest campaign I've ever been engaged in.
Yeah, it's the weirdest campaign I've ever covered, and I've already covered two other Donald Trump campaigns. This is how weird things are. The president of the United States is talking about the election like a Teamster who got dragged to an art show. What the hell is this weird crap? An arm sticking out of the wall holding a banana with Google. This isn't art. I'll tell you what's art. A bunch of different dogs are all playing poker. One of them's cheating. He's got an ace in his back paw. But weird is probably the nicest thing Biden has to say about Trump because in private, he's reportedly said much worse. Politico reported recently that the president has described Trump to longtime friends and close aides as a sick who delights in others' misfortune. According to one of the people who has spoken with the president, Biden recently said to Trump, what a ass the guy is. And look, I get keeping that behind closed doors. In the past, a slip vulgarity was political kryptonite, but so were 91 felony charges. We live in different times, so I say let it rip, Joe. Just start dropping F-bombs on the campaign trail. You're from Scranton. You can get away with it. I love Amtrak. It's the best. It's the best way to travel. I'm not around here. No TSA. There's no metal detectors. Nobody makes you take your shoes off. No joke. So Biden thinks Trump is both an ass weirdo, and instead of trying to prove him wrong, Trump just says, you think that's weird? Hold my beer. And then people say, I think you mean hold my beer. And Trump says, I'm pretty sure it's bear. Over the weekend, Trump posted a side-by-side of half his face with half of Elvis's face with the caption, for so many years, people have been saying that Elvis and I look alike. Now this pic has been going all over the place. What do you think? I think they just meant that you also look like you died on the toilet. That picture looks like Two-Face if he was a musician.
I'm gonna flip a coin. If it's heads, I'm gonna do blue suede shoes. If it's tails, I'm gonna scream about how the water pressure in showers ain't no good anymore.
I'll be ready on the callback, don't worry. And even when he's supposedly talking about actual policy, Trump is still a weirdo and a liar. Over the weekend, he was asked about his trade policies, and instead of defending them on the merits, he told yet another weird fake story about people coming up to him with tears in their eyes.
Your critics are saying that you're going to start another trade war with
China.
It's
not a trade war. I did great with China with everything. Look, China came in, they were going to destroy our steel industry, and I put tariffs, big tariffs, 50% to 100%, but 50% for the most part. It stopped it. I have steel people that every time they see me, they start to cry. They hug me. They said, you saved our industry.
The fun thing is, with Trump, you don't know if he means people who work in the steel industry or people who are made of steel.
The steel people, they cry, and it's very sad when a steel person cries because the tears roll down their metal faces and into their steel joints. And then they rust. The steel people rust, and they can't come up to you anymore. You have to come up to them because they're frozen in place, and you go up to them, and you get very close, and they whisper, they go, Mr. Trump? Oil me.
Trump is such a weirdo and shameless liar. You can even see it in the faces of the people interviewing him. Fox anchor Maria Bartiromo, for example, asked Trump about the soaring economy. And even Bartiromo, a huge Trump supporter and fellow crazy person, seemed taken aback by Trump's attempt to take credit for it.
The Biden team can say, well, if things are so bad, how come the stock market's on a roll?
Because they think I'm going to be elected.
That you think the stock market's rallying because people think you're going to be elected?
I do, yeah.
Look at her face. Either she's having a moment of existential panic where it finally dawns on her the guy she's interviewing is a pathological liar who's detached from reality, or she's thinking to herself, is that Elvis?
Hey, Maria, I can tell you're checking out my face. Yeah, right over there, that's the king, and that's not the king, and that's... Here's what I'm gonna do for you, Maria. I'm gonna flip this coin. If it's heads, I'm gonna do Viva Las Vegas. And if it's tails, Maria, I'm gonna start talking about windmills chopping birds' heads off. And just FYI, Maria, I'm almost done. Don't worry, Maria. The coin is double tails.
Of course, the real reason the stock market is up is not because of Trump's poll numbers, but because of the roaring economy, which got even more good news on Friday with a blockbuster jobs report that stunned everyone. Even Fox News was taken aback by how good it was.
We are just about getting these numbers shortly. We're waiting on the jobs numbers, where we're expecting 180,000 jobs created in the month of January, and the unemployment rate to tick higher to 3.8%. We are watching the revisions, of course, and we're also looking at production.
I got it.
You got the numbers?
Wow.
All right, let's get right to Cheryl.
This is something. 353,000 non-farm jobs. I had to seriously double check this, guys. The unemployment rate went down to 3.7%. That's the actual number. We were looking for 3.8%. Let me give you the... I don't even know what to say here.
The way they react to good economic news when Joe Biden is president is the same way I react when my wife tells me her girls' night out was canceled.
Oh, that's cool. So now you'll be here with me all night. I'm gonna turn off the basketball game and try to figure out a lie for why an obscene amount of Chinese food's about to show up.
That's how you know the news is good for Joe Biden. Fox News double-checked it. If it was good for Trump, they'd air it without even single-checking it. I tuned in this morning and the headline was, Trump and Elvis have same face, no need to look at picture. So the economy's been booming under Biden, which is not what many were predicting. When inflation was still soaring, almost everyone thought the U.S. would end up in a recession. Instead, the U.S. had the best recovery in the world. By contrast, Trump was the first president in modern U.S. history to leave office with a net job loss. Now, yes, Trump was president during COVID, and that had a lot to do with it. But he also brags about how low gas prices were in his term, and that was only because no one was driving anywhere. Of course, gas prices were low. You couldn't even drive to the grocery store to buy toilet paper because they didn't have any. I had to use cue cards. I used cue cards, you hear me? And you can't flush those down the toilet, believe me. After some monologues, I've tried. The economic news has been so robust, Fox hosts who worked for Trump, like Larry Kudlow, Trump's former economic advisor, have had to come clean and admit the numbers are good for Biden.
We had a blowout jobs report. More than twice the consensus expectation. Now, I know many of my conservative friends are trying to drill holes in this report. But you know what, folks? It is what it is. It's a very strong report. Not every economic stat should be viewed through a political lens. I've been in this business a very long time, and sometimes you just have to throw away the ballot box and just recognize the numbers. They are what they are. This was a very strong report.
How mad do you think Trump was when he saw that? His aides are probably still trying to scrub the ketchup stains off his TV. The economic news has been so good, even Republicans and Fox News have to admit they were wrong, which is why they're moving on to other issues they think can exploit, like immigration or a bunch of absurd impeachment investigations in the House. Anything to distract from the fact that their nominee has been indicted for trying to steal classified documents, for trying to steal votes. Hell, if Trump could get away with it, he'd probably try to...
steal people.
Caught me off guard. Didn't see it come. This has been A Closer Look. Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching A Closer Look. And as a reminder, my brother Josh and I have started a new podcast called Family Trips with the Myers Brothers. We hope you listen. We hope you like it. And see you soon.